In this video, we're going to talk about correlation and regression, and we will focus on two big things. Number one, understanding terms and what the questions are asking you, and number two, understanding how to use the calculator to make solutions to these problems fairly quick and fairly easy. If we look at this paper here, it says introduction. Look at page 7 of my outline. Here is the bottom part of page 7, this white area here. You see it says Chapter 10, Correlation and Regression. And this is page 7. You'll just take my word for it, although let me see. There you see the 7. And we're going to be covering each of these areas. So if you have my outline, you can refer back to it and follow along as we address these different types of questions. So, a correlation exists between two variables when the values of one variable are somehow associated with the values of the other variable. For example, there is probably a correlation between the outside temperature and ice cream sales. When the outside temperature goes up, ice cream sales go up. This is called positive correlation. Outside temperature would be called the explanatory variable, and ice cream sales would be called the response variable. Conversely, there is also probably a correlation between the outside temperature and jacket sales. When the outside temperature goes up, jacket sales go down. This is called negative correlation. The other big term here is regression. This whole chapter is about correlation and regression. When there is a correlation between two variables, that can be shown in a pattern on a graph called a scatter plot. When the pattern is linear, it is called linear correlation, and the line is called the regression line, or the least squares regression line, which means the same thing. As you remember from algebra, every straight line has an equation, which we usually learn as y equals mx plus b. You see that highlighted right here. In statistics, this is called the regression equation, and we use it to make predictions. We predict the value of the y variable, the response variable, based on a given value for the x variable, or the explanatory variable. For example, we could be given a specific outside temperature, which again is the x variable, and asked to use that to predict ice cream sales, or the y variable. If there is linear correlation between the x variable and the y variable, we would predict the y variable by using the regression equation. So let's do a problem. I think the easiest way to learn this subject is by doing problems, so we're just going to jump right in and do that, exploring most of the topics covered in Chapter 10 of the Triola textbook. Here you see problem 1. Global warming, that's the title of the problem. Concerns about global warming have led to studies of the relationship between global temperature and the concentration of carbon dioxide. Listed below are concentrations in parts per million of CO2 and temperatures in degrees Celsius for different years. So this table is giving you year by year, and they don't tell you what year it is, but it doesn't really matter. They're telling you for this particular year, the CO2 level was 314 and the temperature was 13.9. And then in this year, the CO2 level was 317 and the temperature was 14, and so on. I think there's 10 different years represented here. And this table is adapted from the Triola text, page 511, exercise number 23. Number 1 here says, what is the explanatory variable and what is the response variable? The theory in this question is that the CO2 level explains the temperature level. So CO2 is the explanatory variable and temperature is the response variable. When we create a scatter plot, the explanatory variable will go on the x-axis and the response variable will go on the y-axis. Question number 2. What are the hypotheses? With correlation, and I'm going to interrupt myself here, correlation is a hypothesis test. So much of the procedures we have used to do hypothesis testing before apply equally to correlation, and that starts off with the hypotheses themselves. With correlation, the hypotheses are always the same. There is a technical way to state the hypotheses and a simplified way to state the hypotheses. Here is the simplified way. HO, or the null hypothesis, is simply that there is no significant linear correlation. H1 is that there is significant linear correlation. And here's the technical form of the hypotheses. HO, this thing that looks like a P, that's really a Greek letter called rho. Rho equals zero. That's the null hypothesis. Rho does not equal zero. That is the alternative hypothesis. Okay, number three, construct a scatter plot. You can do this by hand on the calculator or in Microsoft Excel. So here are the steps on the calculator, and we will do this. First, you go to the Y equals button and clear any equations that might be in there. So here's the Y equals button. I'm going to click on that. And there you see an equation. I want to get rid of that equation. So I'm just going to hit the clear button. Now it's gone, and that's what you want. You want that screen to be nice and clean. Then it says, put the explanatory variable data into L1 and the response variable data into L2. Well, I have already done that in this calculator here. So here you see in L1, there is all the numbers from the top row of that table. And in L2, there are all the numbers from the bottom row. These are the CO2 levels. These are the temperatures. So you might want to pause the video now while you go ahead and enter those numbers into your calculator. Then after you've done that, we're going to go to Stat Tests Lin Reg T Test. So Stat, we arrow over to Tests. And we can actually get to LinReg by arrowing up. We can get there faster. So here we see LinReg T test. So I'm going to choose that. And there you see what we want to have. L1, L2, because our X list, the explanatory variable, is L1. The Y list, the response variable, is in L2. Frequency is always 1. This thing here is always does not equal 0. Now, Reg EQ, that stands for regression equation, you may very well have a blank space there. And if that's the case, you're going to want to change that to Y1. So I'm going to come down there and go through those steps. You're assuming that this is blank, you're going to hit the VARS button. You're going to arrow over to YVARS. You're going to hit Enter. You're going to hit Enter again. And then you should get a Y1 there, and that's what you want. We will then go down to, we're doing the scatter plot here. Yeah, we can go ahead and hit calculate there. So we'll come to all this stuff a little bit later. But now we want to create this scatter plot. So we're going to hit second and Y. So here's second and Y equals. Says turn off all plots except plot 1. Well, in this case, these are already turned off. So we want to make sure plot 1 is on. So we're going to choose that. We're going to simply hit enter. You want to choose this pattern. This is the dot pattern, the scatter plot pattern for the kind of chart you're going to get. Your X list again is L1. Your Y list is L2. Each point is going to be marked with this shape right here. And once that's all in there, you can hit zoom 9. And here are all the points in your scatter plot. And this line here, we'll come back and talk more about that line later, but that is the regression line. You can find the coordinates of each point by hitting the trace key and moving it from point to point with the arrow keys. So if we hit trace, you see this point here is lit up, and it tells us that the x-coordinate is 314 and the y-coordinate is 13.9. That was the first point in our data table. You can find the limits of your window by hitting the window key. So that tells you that window we looked at a minute ago, on the x-axis there was a minimum of 308.5, and on the x-axis there was a maximum of 374.5. Same thing with the y-axis. And you can play with the size of your window if you want. Then when you hit zoom 9, you're telling the calculator to set its own window limits. So let's go back and take another look at that scatter plot. Let's look at number 10 here. Notice that the pattern of points goes up as you go from left to right. This is positive correlation, because as the x variable goes up, the y variable goes up. Now we'll talk about the steps in Microsoft Excel. The first step is you enter the data. The second step is you select the data. The third step is you insert scatterplot. So here I have entered the data. Now I'm going to select the data. I'm going to click on insert, and here we see something that looks like a scatter plot, and indeed we're going to choose this right here, and there is the scatter plot. I'm going to move this up a little bit. To show the regression line on the scatter plot, you click inside the graph, you click on chart elements, and you click trend line. So first we will click inside the graph and click chart elements. So when we clicked inside the graph, we got this, and this little plus sign here, that's chart elements. So we're going to click on that, and we're going to click trend line, and there you see the regression line. Now we want to show the regression equation. So we will follow these steps. We will right click on the regression line, we will click format trend line, and we will click display equation on chart. So we right click on the regression line, we click format trend line, and down here you see display equation on chart, and there you go. And it's sort of obscured by these points here, so we can move it around anywhere you want. So there you see how to create your scatter plot and your regression line and your regression equation in Excel. And we will talk later about what this regression equation means, but for right now you see how to portray it. Number 4, find the value of the linear correlation coefficient. And the symbol for that is R. This is a term you have to get very familiar with, the linear correlation coefficient. So we're going to do that now, and this process should look familiar because we did a little bit earlier. We're going to go to Stat, Tests, Linreg T-Test, Stat, Tests, arrow up to Linreg T-Test, hit Enter. Everything is the way we want it. We talked before about how to put that Y1 in there for Reg EQ, which is regression equation. And you'll notice here, you shouldn't ever have to change these. Once you've set these up, they should stay the same. So we're going to go on down to Calculate and hit Enter. What does it say here? When you hit Calculate, the calculator will give you a lot of stuff. Scroll down until you see R. So let's scroll down. And there you see R, 0.89197, etc. That is the linear correlation coefficient. In this case, R equals 0.892. So I've rounded that to 3 decimal places from here. So what does R tell you? If you have perfect positive correlation, that is, the points form a perfect straight line pointing up, then R equals 1. If you have perfect negative correlation, that is, the points form a perfect straight line pointing down, then R equals negative 1. In other words, R cannot be higher than 1 or less than negative 1. The closer R is to 1 or negative 1, the stronger is the correlation in the sample. The closer R is to 0, the weaker is the correlation. Testing for correlation is a hypothesis test. That means we can use the p-value method, which we'll talk about a little bit below, or the traditional method. If we use the traditional method, we compare R, again that's the linear correlation coefficient, we compare that with the R critical value, and we're going to do that next in number 5. So here we go, number 5. Find the R critical value. Table A5 in the Triola textbook is the table of R critical values. To find the R critical value, you need to know N, which is simply the number of pairs of data, which in this case is 10, and you need to know alpha, or the significance level, which will be either 0.05 or 0.01. Let's assume that alpha is 0.05. If you look on the table, you will see that when n equals 10 and alpha equals 0.05, the R critical value is 0.632. So let's take a look at that table. So here's the table. Notice this is table A5 over here. This is table A6. We're just looking at table A5. So here's the column for n. We come down to 10. Here's the column for alpha equals 0.05, and here's the column for alpha equals 0.01. So we come down to the 0.05 column, and n equals 10, there you see the R critical value is 0.632. Now we're going to determine whether there is sufficient evidence to support a claim of linear correlation between CO2 levels and temperature. Remember, correlation is a hypothesis test. Like all hypothesis tests, you can use either the traditional method or the p-value method. First, we're going to do the traditional method. There is a significant linear correlation if the absolute value of the R correlation coefficient is greater than the R critical value. We found our R correlation coefficient of 0.892 in number 4 above. This is positive. In other words, just saying this is not a negative number, this is a positive number. If it had been negative, we would use the absolute value, which basically means just dropping the negative sign. We also found our R critical value of 0.632 in number 5 above. 0.892, the R correlation coefficient, is greater than 0.632, the R critical value. So we do have significant positive linear correlation. And again, it's positive because R is positive. Well, what about the p-value method? If we go back and look, and I've repeated the process of here of going to Linreg t-test, if we go back, when we hit calculate, the calculator gives us all this stuff, and then we look for p, and there is p, 5.219 blah blah blah, e to the negative 4, and there you see it. Well, this e to the negative 4, if we write it in standard decimal notation, it's 0.0005. Because the negative 4 means you move this decimal point right here 4 places to the left. So you bring it this way, and you're going to fill in all those new spaces with 3 zeros. This p-value is less than alpha, which we have assumed to be 0.05, so we reject the null hypothesis. Reject the null hypothesis. Remember, the null hypothesis says there is no correlation. So when we reject that, we are saying there is correlation. More precisely, we have significant positive linear correlation, which is the same conclusion we reached using the traditional method. I'm going to stop this video right here, and we will pick up right where we left off in part 2, in the video that will be part 2 of correlation and regression.